Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Go ahead, Frank.
I'll address that question first. In order to reduce spending, we need to make some tough choices. And those tough choices are that some people that have entitlement programs that are out there benefiting from the generosity of the taxpayer are going to have to suffer. Individuals that are hardworking in a capitalist society, if you go to work and you earn money, you should keep the majority of that money for yourself. Now, I'm not uncompassionate, and I do feel that there are some people that do need help for a short period of time. We should not have a system that manifests itself in the Commonwealth where we let people get on subsidies. We let them get on, for example, EBT, which is very well documented as a system that has abuses, and we shouldn't allow them to perpetuate that mentality. We want to encourage people by giving them an opportunity to get up, go to work, and to be productive in society. And lowering taxes allows companies to expand payroll taxes, and we see more revenue coming in as a result of that. So some people are going to have to take some tough choices, and that is reduced entitlement programs, I feel, will cut a large portion of our budget.
I'm going to have to disagree with Frank on something that he said. The idea that our citizens are going to have to suffer is untrue in order for us to cut spending. But as candidates, as Republicans, we have to be bold in our solutions. Now, the biggest things that our federal government is facing is the entitlement programs of Medicare, Medicaid, and Social Security. Now, we can reform those programs so that they are sustainable for our seniors and that they are there for future generations. Paul Ryan put together a very bold plan that puts more power in the consumer's pocket, in the individual's pocket, on choice, on consumer choice of where they spend their Medicare dollars. He also recommended moving Medicaid as block grants to the state, which run it more efficiently and get rid of the bigger, bloated, wasteful bureaucracies that we have in Washington. Again, that wouldn't necessarily mean, well, it wouldn't mean at all that our citizens would suffer. What it would mean is it would provide a stable environment for those who would, for our seniors and those who are planning on retiring soon. Now, also Social Security. Now, if you go to jeffin2012.com, I have a one-minute video of my Social Security plan, but we also need to reform the whole structure of Social Security, because we have to phase out the idea of a defined benefit plan and move it more towards a defined contribution plan. And as we do that, we lower the burden for the federal government and the taxpayer. Again, we can do these things. We can provide solutions, and we will.
I just want to make a comment. I think it was misunderstood. My colleague here said that I was quoted allegedly of saying that citizens would suffer. It should have been clear from my discussion that I was referring to those individuals that are receiving the benefits as of today. Those are the people that I'm talking about suffering.
Well, and I said I disagree with you. I don't think that our citizens don't need to suffer. We can structure the plans in a way that is responsible and takes care of our seniors and future generations.